starting to get a little lighter there, but we do still have that little band that's stretching essentially right across the center of our area. So here it is on Storm Tracker. I'll zoom in for you. It is moving pretty slowly. This is right along a stationary front. As that front sits across our area over the next day and a half, we will find some showers out of that, and they'll be kind of shifting on and off, or north and south rather, and on and off over the next several hours. So light rain up towards Schuyler Falls through Burlington down towards Essex, and then you got the steadier stuff that's a little heavier towards Addison, Middlebury, Rochester, stretching all the way down into New Hampshire, and then you've got it over northern New York too, North Hudson, North Elba, likely towards Tupper Lake, and to find some of those moderate showers at the moment, but not too bad. Here, just watch out for some slick road conditions. At least our temperatures are pretty mild. Low 50s now in the Champlain Valley. Even Saranac Lake isn't too bad at 48 there, 49 in Montpelier, 51 in Lebanon. Just a little bit soggy. Heading into the afternoon, still on the cooler side, but maybe not quite as chilly as it has been. 63 for Plattsburgh, 66 in Newcomb, 61 in Malone. Light wind out of the south, southwest, southeast, kind of a variable wind almost. 66 for Morrisville, 62 in Island Pond, 69 towards Middlebury. That'll be nice for you folks, but Burlington will be up near 60. For the afternoon, and a mostly cloudy sky with those intermittent showers that you'll be watching out for. Now, the warmer air to the south is because you folks are actually on the warmer side of that stationary front. So you in Springfield will be near 74, 72 in Plymouth, 76 in Arlington. You can see that stretching right across our area based on where these showers are. So here they are towards about the afternoon and evening hours, obviously not very widespread, but this front will slowly start to lift a little bit further north. That is going to bring us more rain in the overnight hours. This is around midnight. Yellows, oranges, that's that heavier rain. You might even hear a little rumble of thunder in the overnight hours, but the overnight hours through early tomorrow morning is when that rain will be at its heaviest. Most of it will be out of our hair by the morning commute tomorrow. It's just a few lingering showers. It will be damp though, and then we dry up, and we have a much drier Thursday afternoon and Friday in store for us. We just have to get through some of these showers again on and off throughout today, mostly spotty in nature, a little heavier and more widespread tonight and through tomorrow morning. Friday, a little cloud cover here or there, but an otherwise dry day, and we've got a really nice weekend in the mid and upper 70s and dry for Saturday and Sunday.